More and more we are seeing diversity in Hollywood films and television, but change has been slow going. Here in Baltimore, there is one foundation that not only encourages minorities in their film projects, but helps fund them as well. The Saul Zaentz Innovation Fund is helping young producers bring their projects to the public that tell stories that empower while sharing experiences that need to be heard by all of us. Joining me this morning to talk about how they do this and how you can get involved is the director of the fund and head of Nylon Films, Annette Porter. Good morning, Annette. Welcome to Maryland Perspectives.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
So let's start with your film company, Nylon Films. What kind of content are you making, and how does it fit into the SZI fund?
Nylon Films is a company that makes factual content. And by that, I mean nonfiction work for NGOs and corporations, and also documentary, feature-length documentary films. We've been always drawn to bringing stories out that have been in the shadows or excluded from being told, whether because they weren't known or because people didn't have access to telling them. And a couple of the recent pieces of work that I've been involved with is a series of five films that we produced for the Campaign for Female Education in Ghana. And it was helping five Ghanaian women tell stories about their lives and how education had changed their lives, and teaching them actually how to make films themselves and how to use films and internet to market the work that they were doing. We've also just are completing production on a film about the first female conductor of a major symphony and one of our Baltimore gems.
Yes.
Other films, we made a film about a woman named Mary Heath, who's the first person to have ever flown from South Africa to London and in the 1930s, and then died penniless and forgotten. And we were able to retell her story. So those are the kinds of things that we're really attracted to.
They sound fascinating. And you're also working internationally. So when it comes to the SZI Fund, what are they looking for when it comes to content to champion? Are they working internationally as well as domestically?
You know, it's interesting. The kinds of content that we're looking for at Saul Zaentz is less topically dependent. We're looking to support Baltimore voices. These are the stories that Baltimore residents are compelled to tell. They may be about Baltimore. They may be about international stories, but it's really the stories that come from their background, from their experiences, the ones that these creative artists want to bring out to the public. So those are the ones we're interested in telling. And it's across the board, the kinds of films that they want to make. And we support documentary and non-documentary films.
And what kind of films have you released so far? What kind of stories are being told?
The recent crop of stories in the process of being produced now, we've got a couple of Baltimore stories. One is a documentary about the Squeegee Boys. I think most of us have come into contact with them here in Baltimore. There's a couple of filmmakers, Gabe Dinsmore and Clark Lyons, who are filming that and actually following the kids who are trying to make a living doing squeegee work at corners. We've got another project called Rocket to Venus, which is being made right now. And that is a group of filmmakers who are following the story of a rocket that was being made in Baltimore years ago in the garage of someone's house in Hamden. And the idea of this gentleman was to fly it to Venus. So they're trying to track down the rocket. And it's a fun travel story and a science story looking into where that is. We've got stories about artists named Rule Middleman from here. We've got a fellow who's developing a script called Days in the Wake, which is about a father who has abandoned his children at a care facility and the oldest daughter and her attempts to bring all those kids back and raise a family without him. So it really is, and that story originated in Nebraska.
Okay.
So it's across the board, but they're the stories people are compelled to make here.
Yeah, it sounds like you've got some really heavy stuff, and then you have some fun kind of things like the rocket to Venus, which I'm so not shocked that that was trying to be made in Hamden. It sounds so Hamden.
A quirky Baltimore story for sure.
So where can people see these? Do you have to go to a theater? Is it part of the Maryland Film Festival? Is there a place online where people can watch them?
Well, you know, the Maryland Film Festival does bring some of them to the festival. And we had Finding Phoebe, a film that was shot in West Baltimore by one of our fellows last year who was there. So, and then periodically through the year, we bring them to the film festival as they become finished. Most of our filmmakers take them through the film festival circuit.
Okay.
and with hopes of distribution. We've had some go on to Sundance, others go on to other festivals that are Oscar qualifying. It's exciting for them, and it's kind of an early lift to their careers is what we're hoping for.
Now, is it just film that you're working with, or is it a whole bunch of different medium? Like, are you doing television productions? Are you doing YouTube videos, different things like that?
It's not just film that we're producing or that we're supporting here. We support films, obviously, both narrative and nonfiction films, but we also have got web series that are in the works here. We've got a web series about a group of nurses by a first-time director. We've supported apps in the past. We've supported performance art. We have supported television series.
Wow.
So it really has run the gamut. It's primarily film, but we're supporting virtual reality and augmented reality pieces now as well. I think the common thread from all of them is that they're strong in story.
And it's all about that bottom line, too. So you have this great idea. Say you're a young person. You have this idea. I really want to, you get it down on paper, but now I need to produce it. So funding is always the crucial part of all of these projects so that they can see the light of day. So what else are you doing? Once a person comes to you, applies, you accept them, and they give you the script and you say, wow, this is great. Do you help them put a plan together to make this project? Do you help find people to work behind the scenes? What else are you doing?
Yeah, that's a great question. And I often sort of quip that people, you know, come for the money, but stay for the mentoring. So, you know, seed money is very difficult to find for new filmmakers. And we pride ourselves, we put about $500,000 a year into the market, into new filmmakers' hands. But I think probably as important, or from the fellow's perspective and what they've shared with me, more importantly, is we mentor them. We pair them up with industry leaders who mentor their projects, help them develop them. We pair them up with producers. We pair them up with people in distribution. So they have a strong sense of mentorship and also networking with those folks. And we also run some very full-on labs for them where they work on their films together and within these industry mentors. And finally, we have a series of workshops which are open to all the fellows and also to the public. So they may be on legal issues, or they are on producing full stop, you know, or production financing.
Right.
So we run a lot of workshops throughout the year. And then we also bring a lot of directors to the Parkway. Then we open that up also to the public, so that you can go and see free films and talk to the directors afterwards. And we think that's a really important part of trying to help bolster the film community here in Baltimore.
So what's the criteria to apply for funding or for mentoring?
The criteria really is that you're a Baltimore resident.
Okay.
It's open to all ages. We've had applicants as young as 16 and as old as 72. We encourage people to apply. We've just closed our recent round of applications, and we're evaluating those now. But every year we open the fund, and we encourage people to apply with their ideas. The first round is evaluated, and we have a series of fellows, and then those fellows can apply for funding. So we have a kind of a constant series of people in production and then people coming in as new fellows.
For listeners who love to be patrons of the arts, like myself, what can we do to help the funds with donations or volunteering?
There are a couple of things, really. I mean, one is to stay in touch with the Parkway Theater and see what's going on there, because we do run a lot of our projects out of the Parkway. And it's great when we do bring directors to town that they have a full audience. And it's also a wonderful opportunity for people to actually talk to people who are making the films and see our young filmmakers when we put them there. We've got a website, zaentzfund.com, and I encourage people to go there and keep up with when we have our call for entries come out, and please apply, sign up for the workshops. And we're always looking for partners. We want to expand the funds that we have for fellows. We want to expand the event. So if you are interested in volunteering, if you are interested in becoming a partner with us, drop us a line and we will get right in touch with you.
Annette Porter is the director of the Saul Zaentz Innovation Fund and Nylon Films. I'll make sure I get those links up on our website, 98online.com. And Annette, thank you for telling us about the important work that you and your staff are doing to bring more stories that represent underserved communities to the public.